Welcome. Hello everybody. This video is just an update about those 12 Israeli men accused of taking part in a gang rape of a British teenager. And of course, all the enraged brigade are out, you know, saying that it's a travesty and the female is being treated badly and she's the victim. And the mothers come out saying that she wants to boycott tourism to that place. Well, of course the mother does, doesn't she? I mean, this isn't just hearsay or anything. It went to court. People in the court voted and witnessed and looked at the facts and came back and said the female was lying. But we can't find out that women lie, can we? We must push the narrative. Females are not allowed to be held accountable for their actions. And lots of people have seen this story and can read between the lines, can't they? Especially men, because it's them who is affected mostly. And decent females out there should get together and shame this female like men would do in the same sort of situation. But they don't, do they? And you notice that this news story, or every time you read about it, it's always about the female. It's always about her. She's the real victim. But what about these 12 Israeli men who had to go through hell? Do they have a voice? Is there a big magazine piece about these men and what they had to go through? Of course there isn't. They don't matter, do they? And I can only imagine the hell that they've gone through. The thing is, in the Western world, and a lot of Europe has gone woke. They're pushing the narrative. But not all countries are pushing the narrative so strongly. So this female tried what she would try in her own country, and it didn't work. And of course there's a lot of pressure to pardon this female, of course. And people in this country should stand firm. If you go to another country, you have to abide by their laws. If you don't want to, then don't go to that country. I found a story about one of the 12 men. Very brief, though. But you can understand what he's trying to say and how angry he must be. And is he classed as the victim? Well, of course not. He's just a mere man. And the big saying, of course, from all the females and from all the woke people is there's been a cover-up and she has been railroaded. What a load of trash. This is the result you get when courts actually act the way they should, unbiased, and just go on facts. And this is why a lot of women in the Western world and Europe just plain outright lie and just get away with it all the time. Obviously, I'm not saying that all female rape allegations are untrue, but they have to be looked into and they have to have facts to be proven. If somebody can be convicted without any real proof at all, where is the law really? All men should realize that females don't give a damn about males at all and don't care how much trouble they cause them. And they never really feel sorry for the men, they only feel sorry for themselves. And like I said before, whatever happens to this complete mess that it got themselves into, I believe the first results. I can read between the lines. This young teenager female will not pay the price she should pay. But as it's out in the media, a lot of males can see and read between the lines too. Everybody on this planet should be held accountable for their actions. Everybody. But it seems like some of us have a get out of jail free card and they're born with it. So for Christ's sake, all you males out there, remember this story. So back away, men, from these females. They're far too entitled. Far too self-centered. Just one word from them and you can end up in the clink. A roll in the hay can be nice, but is it worth it? Walk away, guys. Your life and future belongs to you, not to them. Now, don't slam the door on your way out.